with them.
Oh, okay. Only your phone.
Yeah. Or so they stand up by itself on the
So the
So once you're ready to go, just double tap it.
You got to see this guy's hand or something? Yeah,
I
got to see. Yeah,
I've worked
here before,
so I
can see. Okay, good. You got a rest in the bed? That's a good way. You got a rest in the bed? Yeah. You got a rest in the bed? Yeah. You got a rest in the bed? Yeah.
Where was the
light when you see it?
Oh, and he was holding the woman's hand.
I just went up. I was almost being rude. I was just doing it. I don't care.
So it's like they were sensationalizing people with split personality disorder by saying, oh, they're all like,
I'm going to see the first time. I don't know. I'm going to go to the next one. We will send somebody up just to let you know when we will be starting the second act. The second act, the first act will be another 20-minute play called, what is it called? Mother Figure. I don't have any issues with my mother's name. Mother Figure. And it's a very, very funny play, very, very well portrayed by the RADS performers. And as I said, it's about 20 minutes long as well. Straight after that, we will go into the third and final act, and that's called Talk in the Park, okay? And it's basically about interactions nowadays and how they go and not so much how they go. If you could, it would be great if everybody could make sure that their mobile phones are switched off or on silent. And also, if it's possible, not to speak throughout the productions because it can be a little bit distracting to the performers. Alan Ayckbourn, as you may know, kind of focused a lot on love and relationships and kind of things that I never really focused on. basically because I'm very unlucky in love and relationships. Anybody else? I know. Anybody else? No? Just me? Great. That's not awkward at all. kind of by the month of February, you know, supposed to be a month of love. This is exciting. A workplace girl. She wasn't a bit annoying with her boxes of chocolates and bouquets of roses delivered by her boyfriend.
Don't you have a date for Valentine's?
Yeah, I do. Go to the paper. I've tried online dating, but there was just no connection. It's not only about the beauty. I've been on that many blind dates at this stage. I really do think I should have my own guide dog. I really do. if love was blind, then why the hell am I spending so much money on underwear? I went. Anybody watching First Dates? First Dates Ireland.
Yeah.
Do you like it?
No.
It's good, isn't it? I like it. I went on the first date, and guy was good. He was cute. Had real trouble with my name. I said my name is Nolene. It's not awkward, I don't think. But he was calling me Jolene, Arlene, Norling. So I went to the bathroom, when I came back, and I said, oh, I found a fantastic way of remembering your name. I said, all right, okay, cool. What is it? Jack Spratt could eat no fat. His wife could eat no lean. Seriously. I got a text the next day saying, hey, Jack, thanks a million for the date. It was great. Seriously. I don't know. I think all of this maybe came from my mum, you know. She was a bit kind of harsh. She went, sweetheart, don't break a guy's heart. Go for the bones. 206 of us. Yeah. I remember watching Forrest Gump, and his mum had a lovely little motto for him. You know, you all know what it was about life, don't you? was it? Life is a bag of box of chocolates. Yeah. My mother's motto for love was, well, it's like peeing yourself. Everybody else can see it, but only you can feel the warmth. So on that note, the toilets are upstairs. Men are in the first floor, and I think the women have to go another floor. Usual story. And the exits, as you can imagine. So guys, sit back and enjoy tonight's fabulous performance by Rads. It's the weekend, so let's get it started. Enjoy.
Excuse me, sir. I mean, I thought you always got on with them.
Yeah, they're all right.
Excuse me, sir. I mean, you used to be perfectly happy to talk with him in the past. Do you wish to have a drink before you meet, sir?
No, thank you.
Look, you used to be perfectly happy to go around with the advisements.
Yeah, not tonight. I just don't feel like sitting down and...
Clover Sullivan, or lots to Tamador, or lots to Mary Cam, perhaps in season. Scampi, all sorts of scampi, grilled halibut.
Like it if we were just on our own.
Still, I'm not the one who went away.
All the same.
Still, I didn't go off on holidays.
You could have done. Thank you.
I couldn't, I told you. Thank you. Old Pierce over there, he landed me with enough work to last me a year.
That wasn't my fault, Martin.
I'm not saying it was, I'm merely explaining.
Grilled pork chops, tomatoes on a crown, whatever that may be, steak yam, grilled filled steaks, what available. Rump steak, garnish sauce.
I mean, book a holiday at a time when you know I'm going to be busy.
Because if I waited around for you not to be busy, I'd never have a holiday at all.
Come on, darling, this chap wants us to work.
Oh, no worry, sir, no worry.
I mean, it was either a case of my taking a holiday on my own or not having a holiday.
Roast hares with gunpowder with orange sauce, roast green chicken biscuits, roast turkey with cranberry sauce.
I mean, do you think I enjoy going on a holiday on my own?
Waiter, what's the soup of the day?
Minestrone, sir.
Oh. What time do we pick up the kids?
Oh, what time? I told Graham we'd be there in time for lunch.
Ah, end of peace and quiet, so.
At the airport today. I had to get there at 7, got to Heathrow at 10.
Sorry I couldn't meet you.
Didn't expect you to.
Our sale meeting went on all day.
Uh-huh.
Sir, wait, what is the soup of the day?
A minestrone, sir.
Oh.
Do you do eggs benedict?
Eggs benedict?
I should imagine if they did eggs benedict, they'd put eggs benedict on the menu.
We don't actually do it, madam.
I mean, I read the menu.
I was only asking.
Well, I read many very distinctly. I didn't read Expedit.
I don't know.
Wait, I think we need a few more minutes to decide.
Very good, sir.
I suppose you want me to read it to you again.
Marvellous the whole time. Yeah. Baking hot, and it's a beautiful island.
Yeah, sounds it. And now we have one pâté, one smoked trout, and you were?
Pâté maison, smoked trout.
Is the lobster fresh?
Oh yes, madam, I can recommend it.
Then I'll have thermidor with a green salad.
Poulet estrogen for me.
Poulet estrogen, thermidor. Do you wish to see the wine list, sir?
Oh yes, my wife is just back from the sunny Mediterranean. She's probably got a taste of it after 3 weeks.
Oh, very good too, madam. Would you excuse me a moment, sir?
The moment you come back from somewhere, you start.
I'm not starting, Diana. I was merely... Yes?
I was just wondering if you were ready to make an order yet, sir.
No, indeed. We're not ready to order yet. We'll let you know when we are.
Very good, sir.
Every single time you go away, when you come back, you're absolutely...
It was your idea.
But I didn't know they were going to be here, did I?
Still, it was your idea when we came out.
Since the children were away, I thought it would be nice.
It was a lovely idea. Let's enjoy it.
Yes, but I didn't know they were going to be here, did I?
Waiter.
Sir,
you'll be pleased to hear that we have last decided. Mess set ready? Here we go. One pot of shrimps, one grapefruit cocktail, and if it's out of mash, yam, and cheddar, we don't want it. One dough with sole and manure off the bone, one rump steak, just the side of medium rare.
Just a moment, sir. Dover sole off the bone, rump steak, medium rare. Have you decided on a wine yet, sir?
Oh yes, white, Emma, white. Do you want a white?
I don't mind either way. I'm just having half a glass.
Just say red or white.
I don't mind.
Red then. Italian line.
They're at the back of the list, sorry. The wine waiter was off today.
Ah, yes. here we are, Italian. We had a very, very reasonable room at one in the hotel where we stayed.
I thought you went there to work.
I did go there to work. I had to stop occasionally.
My husband's been overworking in Italy. Poor thing.
No, you don't seem to have.
Don't know how he managed to work in all that blazing sunshine.
A bottle of this one here, the 104.
The 104, yes, sir.
How on earth did you cope for 3 whole weeks?
So anyway, the last 6 weeks, things are beginning to move. Somebody up there seems to have her interest at heart.
Mm-hmm.
Smoked trout, madam.
No, that's me.
Oh.
Old Pierce was back this afternoon. Full of the joys of spring he was. I don't know what he got up to in Rome, but he seems to have had a good time with it.
I thought he went on business.
I can't believe it took him 3 weeks to get a contract signed. I know the times are difficult. Mind you, if I was married to Emma Pierce, I'd feck off to Rome as well.
Don't stare!
It's all right. He's got it back to us. She's as blind as a bat.
Oh, no.
I bet he's some bit of Italian signora lined up over there. He always liked to mix business and pleasure.
Potted shrimps, sir.
Thank you.
And a steak for madam.
No, that's for me as well.
Well, I'm sorry. I don't believe you.
That's up to you. That's what I was doing.
I'm sorry. I think you're a liar.
And so the problem was to reallocate staff work schedules so that everyone was guaranteed at least one day off and free, while also guaranteeing normal production.
Yes.
Excuse me, sir.
Which was one hell of a problem. Yes?
Have you chosen a wine yet, sir?
Yes. So say you lost men off the assembly section. You had to ensure that you had sufficient manpower to tide you over the entire 3 day period without any noticeable shrinkage in labour effectiveness.
Martin, he's waiting to know what wine?
Oh, yes. Do you do carafe?
Yes, sir.
Carafe of white, not too sweet.
Carafe of white, yes, sir.
So anyway, we managed it. We put in the report, and Donald Pierce is over the moon. He'd only a chance of glancing this afternoon, but he's very happy.
Grapefruit cocktail, madam.
Thank you.
Potted shrimps, sir.
I'm sorry. I think you're lying.
I beg your pardon. I'm sorry, I beg your pardon, madam. Your toast is there, sir.
Responsibility for the entire AD&J project. Took on the whole lot. Did the whole lot myself.
Yes, I know. You've told me all this before, Martin.
When did I tell you?
I've only been away 3 weeks, you know.
What time are we picking up the kids?
I told Brown we'd be there in time for lunch.
Oh, aim at peace and quiet, so.
Did you miss them?
Honestly, love, I haven't had a chance to miss anyone. Not even you.
I miss them. Dreadfully.
Your toast is there, madam.
Thank you.
Oh, did I tell you? Graham Shutter got that job in Glasgow.
Oh, did he?
I'm not paying for a new part. I'm not wasting money on that.
Just on holidays?
Are you deliberately trying to deny me this evening?
Do you care to try it, sir?
Oh. In the chill side, will do. Go ahead.
Thank you, sir.
That's enough, thank you.
Thank you, madam.
Are you eating that or just leaving it?
Leaving it.
I'll just leave it there, sir. Are you finished, madam?
Yes, thank you.
Was it all right for you, madam?
Beautiful. I'm just not very hungry.
Thank you, madam.
I don't see the point in ordering food if you're not going to eat it. I think this is quite the occasion for this kind of conversation, do you?
I can't think of any better time.
In a public restaurant?
Why not?
Oversoul, madam.
Thank you.
I don't see the point in causing a scene.
I'm not causing a scene. I asked you a perfectly normal question. Who is this woman?
Rump steak, sir.
Who's who? What does it matter?
Because I want to know.
Who said it was anyone anyway?
Oh, come on, darling. I'm not a fool. I'm not a bloody fool.
Runner beans, madam.
No, thank you.
Currants, madam.
No, thank you. I want nothing else.
No potatoes either, ma'am.
Nothing else!
Very good, ma'am.
You're trying to control yourself.
Runner beans, sir.
I tell you one thing, darling. If I ever get my hands on the little whore, I should wring her neck.
Do you mind? Do you mind?
Carrot, sir.
Yes.
You can tell the little bitch that from me.
Potatoes, sir.
Nothing else.
Very good, sir.
Nothing else at all.
Right, sir.
Well, that's what it boils down to, I'm afraid. I'm not the slightest bit interested in your work, and you couldn't give a damn what I'm up to. There we have it. We don't have one thing in common.
Oh, come on. I don't know about that.
Really?
Really? I'm interested in what you're up to.
Nonsense.
It's no nonsense at all.
Cool it, Esther Jean, sir.
These past 3 weeks I've been away, were you even the slightest bit interested in where I was?
I know where you were.
Do you?
Yes, you were in wherever it was, Majorca.
I was not in Majorca, darling, as it happens. I was in Rome.
Vegetables, sir.
Just carrots. Rome? What were you doing in Rome?
I was with Donald Pierce.
Donald Pierce? What were you doing with Donald Pierce?
Donald Pierce.
My God!
Potato, sir. Excuse me, sir.
No, he doesn't.
All right, ma'am.
I'm sorry.
Sorry, ma'am.
No, nothing.
All right, green salad.
Thank you.
Oh my God! How could you do it?
I don't know. I wasn't thinking. I felt.
You really
don't know. It doesn't matter now. It's all over. That's why I told you.
It might be all over for you. What happens when she finds out?
Who?
Emma Pierce. You realize what happened to me?
What?
I'd be out of my ear. Don't you see? Jesus, if you had to pick anyone, why did it have to be Donald Pierce? I'd be out the door, forced to resign, the end of my chance of promotion. That's it for me.
Is that what's worrying you?
Of course that's what's worrying me.
Is everything sufficient for you, madam?
Oh, for crying out loud, I can't believe it. I can't believe it.
Where are you going?
Do you care nothing for me? Nothing at all.
Where are you going?
I'm going to be physically sick.
Ooh. Is everything all right for madam? Thank you, sir.
I said, pull myself together. I said, who is she?
Who is who?
Who is she?
I was just going to pour us some more wine, sir.
No, we can do that ourselves. Go away.
Madam?
You can take this away.
Are you finished, madam?
Yes, thank you.
Thank you, madam.
Excuse me.
Is everything all right, madam?
Perfectly. It's just that I am able to enjoy a meal with a man who turns out to be a deceitful, lecherous liar.
Oh, for the love of Mike.
I'll get you a cloth, sir, just a moment.
Look at this. Look at this. Where's the gents? I'll have to mop up.
It's just through here, so
I'm not sure what you think to do. What the... Good God, hello, Chalmers. I didn't know you were here. Excuse me, I can't believe I missed you.
Oh, good heavens, yes.
Having night out, are you?
That's right.
So are we. Well, oh, my, once in a while, don't you?
Indeed.
Have you finished, or are you...
Oh, yes, I've just finished.
I'll tell you what, I've just got to run to the gents and have a quick bottle, then fancy a quick brandy in the bar.
Oh, that's most nice of you, Mr. Pierce.
Just a quick one. Oh, that'll do, waiter, thank you. Could you bring the bill to the bar, please?
Yes, of course, sir.
And you can put them all on the one, if you like.
Oh, that's most generous of you, Mr. Pierce.
Yeah. 9 seconds.